Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Blue Archive on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Blue Archive and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Blue Archive. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else buddies, to get started we have to launch our favorite internet browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to the current URL that I'm highlighting in green color. Now, you can discover on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type anything, because there's a clickable link in the description of this video and as well in the first main comment. We arrived at this point on our website of Usitility, at which we have an in-depth outline on the best way to download and install Blue Archive on computer. We browse lower a bit and click on the Download Game on PC button. After we click on this link, we get to the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to run to play Blue Archive on the PC. As you can discover here we have some pros of preferring using that emulator. Then, we are ready to proceed to download the Blue Archive by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can visualize here in green color. We then click on it. Of course, the download starts and ends immediately. Here it is, here is located the download. It's a file we have to execute. What we have to do now is to launch the installer, okay, then we need to click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow changes to the device. We have clicked yes. I reduce the internet browser to see the installer better. The installation software is very simple to use. It consists of two possibilities, install, and setup path. I am going to talk about what setup path does indeed. We basically just simply click on it. And then we realize that we have here the path where the emulator can be installed. If we plan to modify this folder we have got to click on the browse button, and now we opt for another folder and set up the emulator where we choose. To keep it simple, just set it by default. I click on back, and therefore I just click install. Great, the setup starts and it will go forward with the download of all these megabytes that happens to be shown on that screen. After you save it on your machine, it might possibly be slightly more or less megabytes. The download rate might go at a higher speed or slower, depending on your internet and according to the velocity of the emulator servers. Today they are running quite fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this time, the emulator happens to be launched automatically. As you can see now, at the bottom of the screen, there is a progress bar that will fill up and when it gets into the finish, the emulator is started for the first time. Believe it or not, the emulator has been launched, here it is for the very first time. Before we continue on, as now you can see, it has created two app icons here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks Multi-Instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon is going to be the only one we are interested in. When we need to start Blue Archive on the PC, we twice click on that icon and launch the emulator. The BlueStacks Multi-Instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved Multi-Instance Manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let me conduct the next step, which is a must-have, and that is to begin to browse the Google Play Store. And we are going to just click on Play Store. As can be seen, the Google Play is started. Here we have to log on. Right now, once we are here, we must absolutely accomplish this following step that is definitely imperative. Therefore we click on Sign In. At present it shows checking info. It can sometimes get stopped at checking info, and it isn't going to progress. In that case, you may try to log in after a number of hours and it'll very likely be resolved. At present we can enter our email and password. The email is required to be a Gmail email address as well as its matching password. For example, you can use the exact same email you're using currently in your YouTube account. So that I am going to type in my information and I will come back immediately after I have done it. That's all, info entered. Here is Google welcoming us and presenting us the twos. We can say yes to them all simply by clicking on I agree. Then, it make us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You can keep it checked it's going to build a backup of your data on this device to Google Drive. I will not select it, you do what you want. We mouse click on accept. The Google Play Store is started by default and automatically. To set up the game, we are required to visit the emulator desktop for Android by simply clicking on this icon marked green colored. Currently that we are discovering the desktop of the emulator, we can see that we have there the install application option. We then click on the button. At this point we come with the game. So let's then click here on the install link that I am presenting now in green color. This will launch the installation. At this moment it is going to download and install the video game. It typically takes quite some time, or it could be extremely fast. It again all varies on our own internet connection. This has actually ended installing. Back to the emulator desktop by clicking this button I'm highlighting in green, that allows you to run Blue Archive for the very first time. I am currently on the emulator desktop, and we are on the way to simply click on the brand new Blue Archive software icon that was created. That game app is launched for the first time on your machine. Here we have it. I can also press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to discuss the volume of the emulator. This is here. We use the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This manner we do not rely on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of your emulator. As well as to take pleasure in the experience to the fullest, we can activate the big screen, for which we have two choices. That is actually the first one. We click on that icon which I am designating in green color. Then the monitor is maximized, having one border on top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. In the case that we need to enjoy the game using all the screen, we hit the game icon. So we would likely already be enjoying the gameplay in full screen function. To get out of the complete screen functionality, push the F11 key. And we might already be in standard screen setting. From now, I am on the way to show you the keyboard mapping, and that is rather enjoyable. That strategy we will certainly be able to utilize the game application far more effortlessly. The first task is to click this application icon. And right now there you will have the ability to make the necessary setups. I will put the standard settings, though if you prefer to change it, you may very well do this without having problem. Clearly, the emulator is fully in our language. From time to time it occurs that the emulator is presented in the incorrect language, such as, in Japanese. And as a result to place it in the right language we click here to the cogwheel. So there within other configuration settings, we simply click on the language drop down. We may very well pick the language we need, Italian, Chinese, etc. When the language is determined, we are going to save, the emulator will restart, and also the video game, next time we run it, would also be in the preferred language. Right now, you can find another detail that we must take into consideration, and it is that we will get an email telling you that a completely new machine has been connected to our Google account. It will definitely check with us if we're the ones who have associated with that device. That's right, we shouldn't worry, since the emulator is behaving like an Android device. And in order to determine which device is being emulated, we visit here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. Be sure to browse here to the model option. And here we learn that the emulator is emulating a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for the tutorial. I hope that you liked it, specifically that you thought it was informative. If that's the case, give it a great thumb up, subscribe to my channel, and any comments, issues or suggestions, put them in the comment box below. You may also leave comments on my Twitch channel, I do live streams from time to time, you have it below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Simply click on any of those instructional videos which are usually appearing on the list of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the upcoming instructional videos. Bye.